Salvete omnes, and welcome to the first lesson of Unit 2. Today, we are going to be learning about second declension masculine nouns. Remember, last unit we learned that declensions are groups of nouns that share the same endings. We talked about how if a noun belongs to one declension, then it always belongs to that declension and can never use the endings that belong to a different declension. The same way that dogs can't switch their breeds. We memorized the endings for first declension nouns last unit. And if you don't remember them, then the first thing you should do is to go back and review those endings. In this unit, we are going to learn about the second declension. Before we look at the endings, let's look at the ways that the first and second declension are similar and different. First of all, the cases are all still the same. Remember, the five noun cases: nominative, which is used for the subject; genitive, which is used for possession; dative; accusative, which is used for direct objects; and ablative, which we have learned how to use to communicate place where. Let's remember that first declension nouns, with the exception of the pain nouns, are all feminine. Second declension nouns, however, come in two genders. There are masculine second declension nouns and neuter second declension nouns. Just as with first declension nouns, when you're writing the words in dictionary form, you must include the nominative, the genitive, and the gender. You can tell if a noun is masculine if the nominative ends in us or r, like amicus, amici, masculine, or ager, agri, masculine. If a noun ends in um in the nominative, then the noun is neuter, like bellum, belly, neuter, or donum, doni, neuter. Now, in the next few lessons, we are going to be looking at the new endings for the second declension. As we do that, keep an eye on the patterns and the ways that the first and the second declension are similar and different from one another. In Latin, once you learn the first few sets of endings, the rest follow similar patterns to those that you have learned before. If you keep an eye on these patterns, then learning the endings will be an absolute cinch. Good luck, and see you next time.